It's time to rise and shine and put your coffee pot on. CDT, Better Daily Times. CDT, Better Daily Times.
If you recognize these sounds, then you know what I'm going to say. If you don't, then I formally welcome you to a whole new family-oriented experience. All the way from Center County, Pennsylvania, these are the sounds that longtime members of the Grange Fair recognize as their morning alarms. The Grange Fair is a local summer vacation that you have to be born into to know about. The fair, then dubbed the Picnic, P-I-C-N-I-K, was started by Leonard Roan in 1874. From all around, farmers joined together for recreation and education on the advancements of agriculture. But what exactly is the fair?
I am Lawrence Buddenbaum, Lauren's grandfather. If you ever saw how many cars they park in their parking lot, you'd just be amazed. A sea of cars, hundreds and hundreds of cars, a sea of tents, a sea of trailers. It's just enormous.
I can't imagine flying over it and looking down, wondering what in the heck is that? I am Judy Buddenbaum, and I am Lauren's grandmother. The fair is a large, fenced-in area, somewhat like a county fair, where there's animals and rides and food. But then there is also the aspect of people that actually live there, which you don't have at any other fair, I don't think, in the country. They live in tents that are set up for them, or else they bring in their RV. And once you're in, you are not allowed to move out until the move-out day.
My mamaw has made the Grange Fair her second home since she was a child.
I was born and raised there. I mean, I was born the 15th of August, and I was there in a huge pot 2 weeks after I was born, maybe. I worked at the boarding house restaurant when my grandmother ran it for many years. And then later, I worked for my uncle that parked trailers and helped check trailers in. And then I sold pumper tickets. I camped in a tent when my grandmother had the boarding house. We had a tent right outside the back door. So I don't even remember how many of us used to sleep in that tent at one time.
My papaw was a convert to the tradition when he met his future wife.
I had no idea what the Grange Fair was when I was a senior at Penn State in 1966. My girlfriend, whose grandmother ran the boarding house at the fair, invited me to come out and help serve and wash dishes at the boarding house.
With 26 acres of land purchased, the Grange Fair found a permanent location in 1890. Originally, the fair was a small gathering of concessions, rides, and Grange exhibits.
My cousin at the time would come, and she liked to ride on the rides. So she would go down and ride on the rides and fall asleep on the merry-go-round, and they would carry her back to the boarding house, sound asleep.
The cooks at the concession stands work day and night to provide visitors with the best experience possible. My mamaw saw that firsthand with her grandmother.
She would stay up till all hours of the night making pies, and then she would go to bed for maybe an hour or two and get back up in the morning and start all over again. She used to have a huge, great big lard can full of pie dough mixture. She would just scoop it out by the mug full and mix it, make pies after pies after pies.
Traditionally, the fair was off the grid and rustic.
There's a few TV stations, not many, but yes, and the cell phone signals are not always the best.
As the fair modernized, the location gained 238 acres, making room for more families to pass their tradition down through the generations. The core aspect of the fair stayed the same as time went by, communal relationships.
When we'd go for a walk with Uncle Paul, you would never just go for a walk. I mean, you'd go about 20 feet and you'd see a person he knew, or a relative, or a friend, and you'd stop and talk. Then you'd go another 20 feet, you'd stop and talk. Another 20 feet, you'd stop and talk. I saw a little kid one time when I was walking. There was a dollar bill laying there on the ground, and this little kid had a string tied to it. And every time somebody would walk by and spot this dollar bill and reach down to pick it up, he'd pull it away. So I thought that little kid was really enjoying himself.
The Grange Fair at Center Hall is scheduled to have its 147th year run this August 20th through 28th. Depending on pandemic restrictions, come check it out for the day. You might even catch a glimpse of my cousin and I as we walk back from the grounds to our trailer.